Peace, fam. What's good? It's your brother B coming to you again live and direct Southside Chicago. You know what it is. Today I want to touch on a topic, man, I think it's pertinent. And that's the whole topic of the same thing I always say, but I want to kind of reiterate some points because it's essential that these points be reiterated. And that's basically, you know what I'm saying, people going from radical rhetoric to actual tangible results, man. You know what I'm saying? And if you ain't want to do no tangible work in the field with the people, get the fuck out of here, man. You know what I'm saying? Cats hide behind rhetoric. Cats hide behind this, you know what I'm saying, concept called revolution. When it comes down to it, they don't have no real program for the people to really uplift the people. They got all these, you know what I'm saying, grand ideas, these grandiose ideas of how they gonna stop global white supremacy. But at the same time, they can't even govern their own fucking household, nigga. They can't govern the building which they live on, the block they live on. They talk about all this motherfucking high lofty revolutionary shit, man. I feel like, you know what I'm saying, cats gotta get out in the field and deal with practical basic necessities and basic realities for the people. I feel like we gotta get down to securing food, clothing, shelter, healthcare, medical care, you know what I'm saying, education for our children, and employment for our people, you know what I mean? We talking about, well, we're not going to do this because it's a capitalist system and us in the jargon. When it comes down to it, man, we live here, man. We live here in this moment, in this particular time. We have to be able to sustain ourselves while we're here. We're not in Black African utopia right now, you know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? I'm not saying we shouldn't strive for that. We shouldn't be idealistic and strive for greater things, but at the same time, we gotta know where we at and build from where we at and establish things from where we at from a practical level. A lot of these motherfuckers don't realize, like Pop was saying back in the day, the whole Harriet Tubman syndrome. That's what I got, nigga. But I feel like I was raised by, you know what I'm saying, my consciousness came from the streets. It came from my family and cats from the neighborhood, ex-gang members and drug dealers. They raised me up into this knowledge because somebody gave it to them. So I feel like it's incumbent upon me as a young Black man to give back to those who gave to me. You see what I'm saying? Like, our babies out in these streets, man. And cats talk about they don't want to feed them. They don't want to educate them. They want to heal them, you know what I'm saying? And engage them on a real level. You see what I'm saying? Cats got all these intellectual excuses that sound good, but they don't really, they baseless, though. They don't really mean shit when it comes down to it, man. We have to, like I said, roll our fucking sleeves up and get out here and go to work. But niggas want to be the in debate team or something like that. But I'm talking about our lives are at stake. We understand it's a generational struggle, but at the same time, in this present moment, we have to deal with what Huey P. Newton calls survival pending revolution. So I'm saying people got this idea, okay, revolution is this in the distant future, man. Nothing's gonna come happen right now in the immediate moment. It's not gonna happen, man. It's reality. Anything's possible, but reality is shit probably not gonna happen. So I'm saying, what are we doing in the meantime, dude? Outside of talking, outside of, you know what I'm saying, discourse, you see what I'm saying? And not saying, like I always say, not saying speaking is not powerful, but it has to be something beyond talking, you see what I'm saying? And then when the motherfucker presents something beyond talking, they want to talk about why they shouldn't be engaged in that activity. Come on, man, if you're scared to do the work, just say you're scared to do the work, man. So I feel like when I'm looking at people, it's always very essential that we critique each other. We have to critique for us to have continuous evolving growth. So we have to critique, but at the same time, we shouldn't criticize each other, you know what I'm saying? Especially if you don't have them set up. Like a lot of cats in the community, we might go against us like a Farrakhan, you know what I'm saying? Now, this thing about Farrakhan I disagree with, but at the same time, he got shit in place, fam. He got mouse all over the fucking world. All over, especially in the U.S., all over, transforming men. He got ministries for people in jail to reform them, man, to make niggas stop beating on their fucking wives, you know what I'm saying, to make wives stop cheating on their husband and sucking dick on the side. He's done that, man. His system, his structure has done that. So, of course, you know what I'm saying, he has some issues. He hasn't been able to keep Salon Bakery open. You know what I'm saying? All this time, all the money he's receiving. So I'm saying he has more room for growth like we all do. But at the same time, unless you're duplicating what he has, dude, if he has something similar or something greater than what he has, you can't really say a lot of shit talk. You can critique him, but it's like at the same time, and be able to support him when he's doing righteous shit. You see what I'm saying? So I feel like Ben Ami, them out there in the Mon Israel, they got something set up, fam. You know what I'm saying? It ain't probably the best shit, but it's something set up and practical and tangible. Niggas can touch and feel and deal with it. So I feel like, man, cats gotta, you know what I'm saying, be real with themselves, man, and be real with their reality. And realize that all this ideology shit, you know what I'm saying, it's very important to get your ideology tight, but at the same time, if you're not willing to do basic, tangible shit for the people, who the fuck are you? You see what I'm saying? Who the fuck are you? If you're not willing to do something basic for the people, you know what I'm saying? So that's what I'm talking about, man. You know what I'm saying? Establishing programs, institutions is going to move us forward. You see what I'm saying? Not just talking about it, but living it. We understand it's not going to be perfect, it's not going to be everything, it's not going to be revolutionary. But if it's going to touch and change the lives of our children, and our women, and our people, fuck with it, G. Fuck with it. And I'm speaking relative to the food program. You know what I'm saying? I chose the food program out of all programs because I felt like it was the most tangible, the most basic, the most practical, you know what I'm saying, the most hands-on. And it's able to connect people from different backgrounds, you see what I'm saying, and different levels of commitment to the struggle. You know what I'm saying? But like people ain't seeing that. We are able to offer alternative media. Cause you know what I'm saying, we being out there in the field on a regular basis is helping to counteract the images of young black males and young black females as being gangsters, as being criminals, as being bust downs and things like that. We're showing, you know what I'm saying, that there are other alternatives out there to live by. We're showing an individualistic society. In an individualistic society, we have people out there showing compassion and concern and care for our people. You know what I'm saying? That's real shit, man. We're not really seeing it. We just looking at it, okay, it's just food, man. It's bigger than food, G. Food is one of the major forms of communion with each other. You wouldn't go by Big Mama house and see you have no food over there, G. You like, man, what Big Mama cook? What auntie cook? What mama cook? You see what I'm saying? Before you go over there. So food is one of the, they call that shit soul food for a reason. People, you know what I'm saying, it's not just because it's macaroni and cheese or greens, it's the fact that your soul was put into that food, G. When you really have love for people, you want to make sure it's an excellent meal, man. You know what I'm saying? So you want to put your love and your energy into the food. When you transmit healing through the food. That's real shit, man. So we don't, like I said, the food program is a small piece of the puzzle, but at the same time, it ain't no lightweight shit, though. You know what I'm saying? And if we can, like I said, we can organize the people to ensure that our people have food on the table, fam. We playing with this shit, G. You know what I'm saying? Like, all the rhetoric in the world, man, should not enable you to offer some beef ravioli. Some ravioli to a motherfucker, some spaghettios. You see what I'm saying? I don't care how deep your ass is, fam. If you can't see the simplicity and the sacredness and offering a black child a coat and a scarf, nigga, when it's cold in Chicago, you can't see the realness in that shit, you're a fucking clown, man. And my estimation, I hope I don't want to be too dogmatic with this shit, but I feel like I take this shit personal, man. This shit is real life to me, man. You know what I'm saying? Me being out there, I see the look in their eyes when they get that fucking pinto beans and cornbread, nigga. I see the look in their eyes. They like, okay, it's like they got hope now. Someone actually gave a fuck about them today. You know what I'm saying? So the food program, we should be extending it all year round, fam. I mean, every day we should be doing this program. Not saying this is the only program. We should have our own farmlands and work with other organizations doing similar work. But the key is doing work and setting up practical programs, not for you and your individual group, but for every fucking body, man. Because a lot of these niggas, you know what I'm saying, use the cloak of revolution to create something for their own individual group where nobody else can really fuck with. You know what I'm saying? The food program, like I said, I've been receiving love from Christians, Black nationalists, Pan-Africanists, integrationists, Hebrews, motherfucking Moors, street niggas, vice lords, some stones came through, disciples. I'm getting through food, we're able to unite the black community, fam. Y'all motherfuckers ain't seeing that shit, but y'all want to have this little clique for you and your other revolutionary friends, quote unquote revolutionary friends, but y'all not doing shit for the grand collective of the community. Are you? Is that even your intent? You know what I'm saying? So I'm looking at these motherfuckers, man, like we gotta realize that outreach is an important part of the struggle. Reaching out to the community, because the community reach out to your ass. You weren't born conscious, nigga. You weren't born a so-called revolutionary nigga. know what I'm saying? Somebody came out and reached their fucking hand towards you. Most of us, 98% or more, were not born with this fucking consciousness, man. Someone gave it to us. And a lot of times with somebody who was outside of our bloodline, they gave us this shit. They gave us this shit. So come on, man. Deal with this real shit. You know what I'm saying? And if you ain't doing the work, nigga, you know what I'm saying? If you ain't out here with the people, if you ain't out here, you know what I'm saying, grinding with them, risking, you know, sacrificing your money, your time, your energy, your resources, and your fucking safety, nigga. You know what I'm saying? Get the fuck on, man. You know what I'm saying? Get the fuck on and make room for real niggas. It's about doing real work. And not saying that you planning and you strategizing being intellectual is not real work, because intellect is very important. But don't knock the field, niggas. You see what I'm saying? Don't knock niggas in the field that's doing the work amongst the people, nigga. You know what I'm saying? We amongst the rejected and despised, man. The youth, you know what I'm saying? The drug addicts, the alcoholics, the winos. We out there with them, fam. And I'm like, man, tell them, like, man, you still God, nigga. As Pac say, even as a crackhead, y'all with a black queen, mama. You see what I'm saying? Deal with this shit, you know what I'm saying? And giving them some encouragement, giving them some love. You know what I'm saying? Because most people get addicted to the drug because of lack of love. Most people become, you know what I'm saying, prostitutes because of lack of love. So I'm saying is, it's bigger than what you see, man. It's bigger than what meets the eye. Like I said, it's just a small portion, small portion of what we about. But at the same time, it's significant too. Don't sleep, nigga. You know what I'm saying? If you want to put in the work, you have no right to fucking say shit. Clown. We out here. Every Friday. And every other, I'm going to try to extend it to Saturday as well, man. So that's what it is. I holler at y'all niggas later. I hope I ain't seem all aggressive or nothing. I don't take this shit personal, but I do take it personal because I feel like niggas be talking, man. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's not about who speaks the best. It's not about who's the most intelligent. It's about him who does the most work. Him who does the most work. You see what I'm saying? And those who are sincere and willing to add on. You know what I'm saying? Anybody wants to create their own little individual group, organization. You know what I'm saying? It ain't about none of that shit. It's about you doing work for the people. You know what I'm saying? Everything we do is a program. It's not another organization. It's another program that anybody can do. Anybody can pick up the food for people. Feed the people program. Anybody can pick this shit up. With your church, your mosque, a temple, alphas, omegas, stones, bloods. You know what I'm saying? Crips, whatever. Anybody can take this program and do what they say. That's what you gotta give, motherfucker, man. Examples, programs, G. And we got many more programs to come. This is just the beginning, fam. But it's the most unifying out there. But I get thrown off when I find out motherfuckers even want to debate that. Like, how can you debate food, nigga? How can you debate feeding people and giving niggas skull caps in the winter? How can you debate that shit, fam? You motherfuckers, I'm confused. Maybe I'm missing something. Y'all niggas tripping, man. You know what I'm saying? Maybe I'm tripping. But we gonna keep doing this shit, you know what I'm saying? Keep moving it forward. Peace to everybody who, you know what I'm saying, show love, who donate to what we do every fucking week, you know what I'm saying? We're gonna continue moving, we're gonna continue, you know what I'm saying, to show love to the people. We're gonna grow and develop, you know what I'm saying? And, become greater people. Greater men, greater women, greater people, you know what I'm saying? And do the work and love and humility. Peace and love, nigga. We out of here.